everybody. Hope you're having a great weekend here. I know we are. We're headed to one of my favorite fossil hunting spots, which is in West Alabama, more northward towards the Mississippi line. And we're going to be looking in the Cretaceous chalk member. There are three specifically here in Alabama. We're going to be looking at the Late Cretaceous chalk member, which is in the Tuscaloosa group, the Utah formation. And hopefully today we'll maybe find some Mosasaur bones, lots of shark teeth are usually promised from this location, and maybe some plesiosaur teeth if we get lucky. So keep you guys updated, we've got more filming to do, and stay tuned. And I want to talk a little bit about gear for this particular site. It's a creek, so we're not really sure what the water levels look like yet. We'll have to take a look when we get down there. But just to be prepared, I do have my water shoes. They are 2mm wetsuit water shoes. They work great for the creek bottom because they've got nice, like, all-terrain tread on the bottom, good grip. I've got my sister here. We've got quarter-inch mesh. This was homemade, so everything can be found, you know, for that, for Home Depot. We've got 2x4 inch, well, actually that's like a 1x4 piece of wood. You've got brackets and you've got quarter inch mesh. Here is a nice trench shovel. These are good, a little bit better than trowels, in my experience, just because, you know, you're trying to move gravel, you're trying to maximize time, right? So you don't want to spend, you know, 3 hours digging as opposed to an hour and a half digging, because you can move twice the gravel with this. So get yourself a nice big trench shovel. They're also good for moving big boulders and, you know, bigger rocks that you're going to find in the creek here. Obviously, I've got my firearm, I've got a carry permit here in Alabama, but here in Alabama you can also open carry. So in case we run into any unforeseen circumstances, whether it be wildlife or whatever, it's always good to have something to defend yourself. I've got a small bucket there. I've also brought some Ziploc baggies for smaller teeth collecting, and the larger bucket will just be for larger bone fragments that I find. So that's about all you need. It's pretty lightweight gear, very minimalist. Anything else I need will be kept in the trunk. We are parked very close to the spot we're going to be sifting through, so everything works out. So let's head down there and see what we can get today.
Your phone's dying again. I think that, yeah.
So we just got to the spot and it's beautiful. The creek is so low, you can see all the gravel. We're going to find some good stuff today. And even just looking over here on the banks, you can see there's teeth. There's a lion here. Avery just found a few. Nice squalicorax right there.
I didn't even have to dig. Look, that's a good one.
Let me see, there's one over here too. I just saw it. I'm gonna try and grab it. Where's that guy at? Oh, there he is. Right here. Yeah, look at that. There we go.
These two are missing their crowns, but they're better half of a half inch.
Nice. Good stuff, man. So I was digging right in this gravel where I usually can't get to because the water level is so high.
And just as an example, there, last time where I'm pointing, that was the last river line, so it's dropped down at least probably 2.5 feet.
So I'm digging, and I find this beautiful mosasaur tooth.
Wow.
Let me try to turn it around so you guys can see. What's characteristic about mosasaur teeth is that they have a front edge, serrated edge. You can kind of see it It's a little bit difficult. I'll take some better pictures of it later and post them at the end of the video.
Oh yeah, it shows up real good.
Absolutely gorgeous. Very conical.
Nice.
You can see the cross section at the top, and you can even see the kind of castellations in the grooves on the tooth still. It's been tossed and turned by the river, but it, I mean, that's pretty darn good for coming out of a sifter.
Nice. Good find.
So what a great turnout today. I am massively dehydrated because it's about 100 degrees, but we made out with some excellent finds. I've got 3 Ticotus teeth here, and I'll take better pictures later. Avery found 2 of them. It looks like we have some smaller baby teeth that probably go either to the sides or to a juvenile. And then, of course, we've got that really nice Mosasaur teeth, which is actually drying out a little bit. As you can see, it's got a real nice dark brown tint to it from the tannins in the river. And then we got a bucket full of really nice teeth. And I'll go through some of these when we get home. A lot of Scaphanorhynchus.
Gesundheit.
Yeah. Scaphanorhynchus texanus, which is a goblin shark. It's an extinct goblin shark from the Cretaceous. That's one of the better teeth we found today from that guy. And I'll point out another one. This is Squalicorax. That's a nice Squalicorax tooth. So all in all, really good turnout today. It's probably one of my favorite trips here. So let's get these teeth home and get them cleaned up. All right, guys. So obviously we made it back in one piece. Don't mind the place. It's a bit of a mess. Still haven't showered yet, so don't mind my grossness. But I just can't wait to look at these teeth. So I want to show these to you guys, and you are not going to believe this. I cleaned this Mosasaur tooth off, and what I'm going to try to do is show it to you under my small Wesley's magnifying glass, which comes with an LED light. And this thing is actually really handy for looking at fossils and different minerals and rocks and stuff like that. But it's a great thing to have. And let me see if I could show this to you guys. So hold on a second. That Mosasaur tooth, all right? I'm gonna move this light around a little bit so you can see how it casts on those ridges there. See that? And let's see if we can get in. Let's see if we can get this camera a little bit closer here. Really look at a magnified view of it. Wow, look at that. Oh, I just flipped it a little bit there. You could see how the enamel is worn off towards the bottom there. As we go up, you can see those ridges and that nice brown starts to show up towards the back end of the tooth there. Really cool. Flipped around here, so let me get a focus in on here. Wow, look at that. You can see where the tip of the tooth is worn. Go up the edge here, see? Get it in focus, there we go. That is so cool. Really nice way to look at this tooth. So let's try it this way too, so you can see that forward edge there. That nice serrated edge that kind of comes to a point. Man, that looks cool. And the back of the tooth, very roundular. Yep, that is a word. And let's see the top here. Oops, give me a second. All right, that is the top portion. There you go, it's a little bit of a better view. It's hard to get the light to catch it there and focus, but you get the idea. Very cool. Ticotus teeth out, cleaned off. There they are. The 2 of them are broken, but this one is just literally a perfect specimen. I mean, it is fully intact. All the bells and whistles. Very nice grooved volcano looking top there. Look at it on magnification. You can see those grooves. And typically when you look at the tooth, the top portion of it here, it looks a little bit more worn, but this one doesn't look as worn to me. So maybe it was only used slightly before it fell out. All right, and let's look at the side of it here. And the crown portion. Interesting. Very cool tooth. So I wanted to show you guys a few of my favorites that I picked out from today, and some of them are just because of the pure, you know, construction of the tooth and how it stayed intact, kind of like that one, for example. And that's a goblin shark tooth. Unfortunately, they're missing their crowns on some of them. They're real fragile and they break easily in the creeks, getting tossed and turned over millions of years. But these squalicorax teeth up here are really nice, and you can see that you get quite a color variation depending on how long the teeth stay in the creek. Their color, the dark colors, depend on how long the teeth kind of get tossed and turned around in the creek. So some of the lighter teeth, for example, you could say came out of the chalk nearby and you know, got washed into the creek and probably haven't been in there as long as some of these other darker ones. So it's kind of my take on that. And then also from this formation in this creek, you could get these teeth that have that nice reddish brown color to them. So that's why I kind of pulled that guy out, to show you the difference in colors that you can get from some of these. Now, that to me looks like three different species, maybe four. I have a hard time myself identifying these Cretaceous teeth, just because I'm going to be honest, I'm not as well versed in all of the specifics and intricacies of each tooth design. So for example, this second row of teeth here, very obviously goblin shark, right? Scaphanorhynchus texanus. But as we get into this lower tier here, where the light is showing, you know, those could be mistaken for Otodus obliquus. Or they could also look like different subsections of a goblin shark's tooth mouth. Just from the research and the experience that I have with these teeth, it can be quite hard for me, at least, to identify them. So I pretty much just go for their beauty. And you can see here, forget what, I think this shark is different altogether. I think that's a different species. And then obviously up here are the squalicorax teeth. I like the squalicorax teeth. They're some of my favorites that come out of the Cretaceous teeth because of their shape. You know, someone who didn't really know what they were looking for could pull one up and just think it was a broken tooth. And I'm like, no, that's actually how it's supposed to be. That's how it looks. So, really cool.
So I hope you guys really enjoyed the spin that I took on this video tonight, showing you guys the teeth through the magnifying glass with the LED light. I think it turned out pretty well. It tends to show you more of the details and intricacies that some of the other videos don't show you. And mainly that's because I don't have the best lighting in here. But let me know what you guys thought of that method. Like I said, I haven't seen it much. So if you want to see more fossils under the magnifying glass with the LED, I could definitely try that for you. So leave some comments. Please like and subscribe. I will be coming out with more content very shortly. I try to keep this channel updated. It's been hard lately with COVID, obviously, to go on trips and different hunts with groups. So I've been having to do them individually. So I will try to keep up with this as much as I can, but I really appreciate you guys watching, and I hope you enjoyed all the finds from today.